Welcome to the Wallara TV Show, the show that celebrates people of all abilities. I'm at the Pakenham Living and Learning Centre. Let's go meet some people and see what they do. I'm with Miriam from Pakenham Living and Learning Centre. So Miriam, tell us what you do here.
We are a Learn Local Community College, a neighbourhood house, a information and referral service, and also managers of community space for the local council.
So how many people would use this facility?
We have 420 students and about 30 different organisations who use the centre, and Wallara is one of those.
We'll catch up with them a little bit later, but here's our next story.
Grassbusters takes people with intellectual disabilities and gives them on-the-job training in horticulture. Jude and Andrew have been coming along to Grassbusters for about 12 months now, and they've become real valuable members of the team. It's one of our Grassbusters rituals as we're driving in between jobs. We've always got rock and roll playing on the radio or CDs, and one of the favourites is Kiss. The moment we put the CD into the slot, it transforms the van into a concert arena. Stuart, aka Gene Simmons, has his tongue out playing air guitar, with Andrew in the back playing drums, and everyone else headbanging and singing along at the top of their voice. These guys were born to rock.
Kiss is best band in the world.
Kiss? I love it. My heart.
It's really great to share that common bond of being a Kiss fan. My first Kiss concert experience was when I was 9 years old, 1980 VFL Park. I've been to Kiss concerts 7 times in total, and I've always either worn makeup or full costume. So I knew from personal experience that if you dress in full makeup and costume, you'll become a crowd favourite and get a lot of attention. And I wanted to give the guys a rock and roll star experience. So the guys and I did some of our own research, and we thought we'd go to the core of Kiss, and we decided to make the 1977 Love Gun costumes. So we all had to choose our character. So every time we played Kiss in the van, Stuart would automatically stick his tongue out and transform into Gene Simmons. Andrew would be tapping away on his knees, and so I thought Peter Chris is the ultimate character. And of course I like guitar and the spaceman, so I decided to be Ace. But we had a dilemma, who was going to play Paul Stanley? So I knew this guy, Andrew G. He's one of our residents at the Wallara houses, and him and I go way back. We've been to a lot of concerts in the past. And I thought, ooh, he'd be into Kiss. We've got to get him along and get him with the makeup on. So here we are, the 9th of October. We're getting ready for the concert at Wallara head office, in the toilets, and one of our guys, Andrew, our Peter Chris, starts hyperventilating and having a panic attack.
When I go to new places, I get nervous.
While I'm colouring in his Peter Chris whiskers, I had to keep reassuring him that it was going to be all right, and in the end, he was going to have great fun. And the moment we arrived at the car park, out the front of Rod Laver Arena, people started to crowd around us for photos. It was an instant transformation. It was exactly what I hoped for. By the time we went into the venue and found our seats, we must have had over 30 photos taken with us. And with every photo, the guys just grew in confidence.
No, I just loved it. Meet people and talk to them and stuff. I said, I'll take some more photos if you want. So I said, I don't mind.
So the moment the concert started, the guys just let loose and just went in the character and just had the night of their life, rocking out and headbanging around. It was an awesome night. The guys came home absolutely knackered, but I reckon they could have gone back for more straight away. So when we got back to Wallara on Monday, our ears were still ringing, our photos were already up on the Wallara Facebook page, and everyone thought we looked great and wanted to know more about how the concert went. So get this, we were asked by management that since we had our costumes and makeup ready to go, the real Kiss concert became our dress rehearsal because they wanted us to perform Kiss at the official Wallara concert. The guys couldn't get there quick enough. Watching them come out on stage was amazing. They were confident, in character, and ready to entertain the crowd. Seeing them on stage, I realised they kissed their fears goodbye.
One of the exciting things about our partnership with Mary Kay is how it provides meaningful employment and training opportunities for people with disabilities. Let me introduce you to three supported employees who do a passionate and wonderful job on behalf of Mary Kay.
Hello, my name is Liz and I've been working at Wallara Logistics for 7 years. Since I've been working at Wallara, I've got Employee of the Year and 6 Employee of the Month. I'm really proud of that. I learnt a lot of new skills and made a lot of new friends. I love picking the orders for Mary Kay. It's a fantastic job it is to do. I really like it.
I've been working at Wallara for about 5 years. Since I've been here, I've got my forklift license and Cert 2 in warehousing. My next goal is to get my truck license. I want to help dropping off and picking up orders. My favourite job is to pick the Mary Kay orders.
I've been at Wallara for 5 years and I love it. I love learning new things and being part of the team and doing the best I can. It makes me feel good. Since I've been here, I have done Certificate 2 in warehousing and I'm really proud of my qualification. My favourite part in Mary Kay is picking the orders. It makes me feel wonderful inside when I know I've done a really good job. I promise to pick your orders and get it right.
Our employees are really excited about the partnership we have with Mary Kay. They take great pride in their work and this is evident by the outcomes that are being achieved.
Don't go away, we've got more great stories after the break.
Transitioning from school to a day service can be daunting. There's a lot of change to be managed. Here at Wallara, we've got some great strategies to support clients through that process. For those who need it, we offer a longer transition period so that they become familiar with their site, their staff, peers, and new routines. Communication between all parties is crucial to the success of a good transition period. We thought it would be fun to get a few of our current clients to come and talk openly, honestly, about their post-school transitions to Wallara. Here are their stories.
At school, we'd sit in the classroom in a lot, but at Wallara, we'd go out for different things.
I did a trial last year, and then they slowly put me 1 day a week. I was really nervous and then eventually I moved up to 4 days a week this year. And yes, some days I still get nervous, but it's part of life. Everybody gets nervous.
Yes, I was a little bit nervous, but I'm fine now.
Going from school to Wallara is not very stressful. The staff help you settle in and making new friends.
At Wallara, they treat me like an adult, not a kid.
Staff that are really helpful.
When you start a day service, you have a meeting with your parents and staff to talk about what you would like to learn and develop and what skills you want to get out of life.
When I came to Wallara, I didn't know what I wanted to do, so I tried lots of different things.
My favourite things is Wallara TV, Wallara Radio Show, and Office Skills at Living and Learning Centre in Pakenham.
My favourite things are Zumba, photocopy and music.
At Wallara, I'm doing Wallara verses for today. Also, I'm doing calls and I'm doing Wallara industries.
My favourite things are cooking, pop-up shop and calls.
Leaving school is a bit scary, but you have staff and your parents helping you learn new things and to go new places. And everybody has their up and downs every day, but we all survived. I reckon you guys should give it a go and try it out and see what you think.
If you want to take the next step to explore what we can do for you, give me a call on 9767 3358.
We're at Pakenham Living and Learning Centre and I'm with Don Martin. So Don, what are you doing today?
I'm doing office skills and I'm typing up stuff with resume and I'm loving it.
That's great. And what's our next story?
Scooby-Doo, where are you? And I'm loving it.
Campbell comes to Wallara's community programs about 3 days a week. I support him in home a few hours a week just to give Mum a break and Cam a rest at home.
The combination of in-home support and Wallara care is a good combination for us because Cam's often unwell and not able to attend the programs. It's hard to leave someone with Cam's high medical needs, and Mel's so capable and I never have any fear that he won't be taken care of. Campbell and Mel have a very special relationship. She's very in tune with his needs and they have a lot of good times together.
Cam's special interest is Scooby-Doo. He has a lot of toys, movies, books about Scooby-Doo. It's very real to Cam and they mean a lot to him.
Cam lives a lot of his life in his imagination, so all of those characters are part of his life. And Mel's understanding of how Cam views his special friends is so important to him.
So I was driving to work and the mystery machine just drove straight past me and I just couldn't stop thinking about how much Cam would absolutely love seeing a real life mystery machine. And I was just thinking about it all day and I just had to find the owner of the mystery machine. So I posted it on Facebook. I asked the local newspaper group if they could help me find the owner. I asked all my friends that were into cars and everyone was really helpful trying to find out who the owner of this car was. The response from the community was really overwhelming. They could see that it would just be a dream come true for him. So Facebook notifications for me were going crazy. Everyone was trying to get in contact with me, asking me if so-and-so had contacted me and blah, blah, blah. My husband was annoyed that I was on Facebook for so long. And then by 9:30 at night, I had a message from Bo, the owner, saying how awesome this is and he's willing to help out, so it was great.
When the mystery machine came down the driveway, Cam couldn't believe his eyes that it was here at his house. He was smiling from ear to ear. He was involved with Bo being Fred. Mel played into the whole experience. It was just fabulous.
Fred is Mel.
Mel?
Yeah. Hello. Hello. Hi, Fred.
How are you? You got the nice grass there going?
Yeah.
When we went for a ride in the mystery machine, Cam was really excited. Bo played his favourite song, Eagle Rock, and we were all singing along. Cam was so happy, it was great to be there.
Mel's care for Cam and her friendship with Cam is beyond anything we could have hoped for. And every day, she is the same with him. What Mel did for Cam was done out of love. She did it all on her own time and it was just such a pleasure for her to make him happy.
It's days like this and helping the people I work with dreams come true is why I love my job.
You shake your hand?
When Mel told me what she was hoping to achieve for CAM, I thought it was just wonderful. And to see it unfold and see her delight in making CAM's wish come true was just the best day ever.
That movie makes me cry.
Suck It Up, Buttercup, we're on telly. And the second half of that story is coming up after the break.
I don't think we can take it.
We're here at the Pakenham Living and Learning Centre's fantastic community garden.
Now we've got a great follow-up story. It's called Scooby-Doo, We Found You.
We've wanted to get CAM a mystery machine for over 10 years. And after Mel organised his special day out with Bo and we saw the joy that it gave him, we decided that we really wanted to get him a mystery machine of his own. All young people have interests. CAM's special interest is obviously Scooby-Doo, and it's really important to us to honour the things that he's interested in. CAM has an extensive collection of DVDs and Scooby toys. We've been to every stage show of Scooby-Doo that's come to Melbourne. For his 21st birthday present, the whole family went to Movie World and he got to meet Scooby and Shaggy and look at the mystery machine. Everything that we could do that's Scooby-Doo, we've done. At a time in CAM's life where he would usually be buying his own car and we'd be helping him out getting set up for his adult life, it's not a possibility for him, and it's really important to us to give him things that give him pleasure.
CAM lives in a world of Thomas the Tank Engine and Fireman Sam and Inspector Gadget and Scooby-Doo. We've always said to him, save money for a mystery machine. Never really thinking that we could deliver, but we decided that we wanted to, and we just wanted to be able to give him something that was his. About 2 years ago, we found a CF Bedford 1976 online in Tasmania. We brought it across on the ship. Mechanically, it was pretty sound. We had to redo the brakes, of course, clutch cable, the steering. The gears were a bit loose, so we had to tighten all that up. And then we wanted it to look something like the Scooby-Doo mystery machine, the same as in Queensland. So we looked online again, and I found some guards and some flares and all those sorts of things that you could buy. We fiberglassed those in. There was a bit of rust around, so we had to take all the rust out of the, mostly around the roof. And then we sanded it all back, and Frank primed it and painted it. And then we got this wrap on it, which I think looks pretty good. So we found it in 2015. I thought it would be completed in about 6 months. But I was completely wrong, and it's now been 2 years, and I'm very proud to be able to give it to CAM this week. It's his birthday this week, it's his 23rd birthday this week, and I'm very happy and very proud to be able to give it to him today.
The week leading up to his birthday, when we were giving him the mystery machine, I couldn't look at it without crying. I'd get a glimpse of it through the fence with Frank, and I'd think, oh my goodness, it's going to be done. And then when the day came, it was just to see it here and see him was just the best. They seeing the van come down the driveway, I was really intent on CAM's face. I just wanted to see what his reaction was. And you could just see when he realised that it was his, he saw the writing on the front, and we talked about that a lot. You know, if you had a mystery machine, What would the writing look like on your mystery machine? So when he saw that it said CAM's mystery machine, it was the happiest, happiest, happiest day.
It's wonderful to be able to present CAM with his dream.
On the day that we gave CAM the keys for his mystery machine, that was his dad's special pleasure. It was just wonderful. And after he got the keys for his machine, he wouldn't be parted from them. He slept with them. He had to have them beside him with everything that he did. And they're still his most prized possession. This could never have been achieved without Frank and Patricia, our neighbours and dear friends. Their love and support and Frank's expertise in restoring cars is what made this happen. Children with special needs can't make their dreams come true on their own. That's their family's job, and it was our great pleasure to make Cam's dream come true.
Hi there, Zach here. We're here at the Sage's Cottage Barn where a special lunch is going to start. And I'm here with Wallara's many staff members, Kate. Good afternoon, Kate.
Good afternoon, Zach. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you too. So tell us first of all about what's happening with the lunch today at Wallara.
Sure. So today is an opportunity for Wallara clients to showcase their hospitality and community engagement skills. We are hosting local students from nearby special needs schools, and they've come here to find out what day services are all about.
That sounds awesome, Kate. So let's have a look at what the team's doing right now. With me now is Rob Morrison from Frankston RSL. Good afternoon, Rob.
Afternoon,
how are you doing?
Jack. Wonderful, thank you.
Now, Rob, why is Frankston RSL connected with Wallara?
Frankston RSL is a community organisation, right, and looks to support other not-for-profit organisations within their region, and Wallara, we feel, is a wonderful organisation helping people with special needs.
And I heard the RSL has provided some chefs to assist with the lunch. What's on the menu?
What's on the menu today? We have some wonderful winter dishes today. We have a minestrone soup, and we've got some chicken carbonara, and we've got some lovely apple pie, which will certainly help the guests enjoy the day, I feel.
Sounds delicious, Rob. Just had a fantastic, delicious main course meal, and we're about to serve the grand finale, homemade cupcakes. And I'd like to say this before I go, a big thank you shout out to all the guys who participated for this lunch, including Frankston RSL, even the guys at Wallara. You're all great guys. Have an excellent day and good night.
Thanks for watching Wallara TV.
For more great videos, head to our YouTube channel, Wallara TV.
See you later. See you.